Hey everybody, it's Jang here with a look at a Lego movie set for early 2015. This is the double-decker couch, comes with 197 pieces. Let's talk about figures first, because they're kind of the highlights of this set. We'll just compare Emmett to a couple older, more common versions of him, and of course all of these have two faces each. So the middle one is the one that comes with this set. I just wanted to show you what they look like compared to each other. And there are all of their alternate faces. Is it just me though? Or is getting a waffle, an official waffle from Lego, really, really exciting? I find any new food item from Lego to just be something to really celebrate. It's so infrequent and they're just such good pieces to have. Benny's back, always good to see him, everybody's favorite character from the movie, and here's an older version of him, so a different, wide, happy, smiling face, and also a thankful face. President Business in this set is pretty happy, that's good to see, and there's his alternate face. Compare that to the most common older version. Also notice that he's buttoned up here. No print on the back whatsoever. Here's an official sitting Unikitty with one of two faces that's included in this set. Here you can see how they pulled off her sitting pose with the tail angled to the side. The second face is not built into this same piece. You actually have to swap out the entire head, or most of it. And there's what that one looks like. There are the two pieces that you have to swap out. You see it's a brick as well as a plate. Both of those are printed. And you just compare those to a older standing standard version of Unikitty just to see how the difference in pose is worked out. Last but not least, here's the Ghost of Vitruvius with the smiley face on the front there. And he does have his headband. That's special. Also, surprisingly, they did not go with a slope piece for the legs. Instead, they went with just a brick, a two brick tall brick. It's a 1x2x2, and that's printed. And he does have the cape there, and he's got his lollipop, shoot up lollipop. You notice that the ghost portion is a little bit greenish. That's because it is glow in the dark. There's what the figure looks like with the ghost shroud removed, if you will, just so you can see how the print goes up. And he's got the black minifigure head with no print on it, compared to one of the originals. And that does it for the figures. The double-decker couch itself is, I believe, the same one, or the same build, as in the Metalbeard Sea Cow set. Maybe there's something that I missed, but it looks to be the same to me. You know, it's pretty close to what you saw in the movie, and it's able to accommodate four figures as long as they don't have anything on their backs. If anything's on the back, then they're not going to be able to sit in the seat normally. But yeah, you know, this is what gives the set its name, but to me, it's nothing particularly spectacular. You know, it's just a couple rows of seats. It had more significance in the movie, and also that comedic element that to me just doesn't come through so much in the toy form. Lastly, Emmett gets his little smart car. This is basically the same build as the ones that came with the cargo train set. So just a super, super, super small Lego car, four studs wide. The tires just barely stick out beyond that, but it is able to accommodate a figure inside of there, and they do have a couple cool elements to it. For one thing, Emmett is able to keep his hard hat back there, so that's a good thing for him. And there's also an exclusive little printed piece in there, the radio, which is tuned to channel radio. So there's what Emmett actually looks like inside of the car. Yeah, he's got enough headroom to fit completely. I actually really like this build, even though it's so small and simple, partly because it's so small and simple, and I really appreciate getting something that's useful, or making something that's useful and makes sense that's really small. Plus, it's somewhat realistic, even though it's so small, and still fits a minifigure. So I'm actually glad to see another one of these. In real life, I don't like smart cars at all, not even a little bit, but in Lego form, I think they're great. Just seeing all this built actually makes me feel a little bit sad that we're not going to get another Lego movie for a couple more years, but I am glad that they brought out another few sets for this theme. This one's not spectacular, but it is good to get some different variants of these popular characters. And again, I definitely like the little smart car. So that's it for my look at this one. Please share your thoughts about it down in the comment section and stick around for more reviews because more are on the way. Talk to you soon.